Hi, everybody. It's Marcia here at Women's True Healing. Wanted to talk today about the butterfly in the pelvis. I was thinking about the Virgin Mary at labor and wondering what it was like for her, and was sorting out my thoughts towards a written piece about my ideas of what her labor or questions about that night that she gave birth to Jesus. And so I'm also thinking, like, you know, what if she did have pleasure, and what if it was an orgasmic birth, and who attended her, and thinking about the angels holding her sacrum and her occiput and allowing her to float, and imagining what that ecstasy would have felt like while you're held in this cosmic transdimensional safety. And I envisioned her pelvis opening up like a butterfly, the sacrum being the body of the butterfly, once was caterpillar, and the hips, the bones of the hips, unfurling like the wings. And so the body of the caterpillar also lengthens, the coccyx being the tail also lengthens, and the top part also just expands to allow for this opening and flapping of wings. And then seeing the cartilage at the symphysis pubis being that which becomes elastic and allows for undulating motions, and imagining that being her experience of the labor. And if we could help women visualize that within their labors as well, you know, could that change things for anybody? And has anybody already even experienced this? Maybe it wasn't just new to Mary, it was new, it is what all women experience. So I was channeling and thinking about this poem and seeing the butterfly in the pelvis in that way. So thinking about the symphysis pubis and the elasticity and the allowing for the undulation, and imagining this was the case for all mothers, because aren't all mothers also birthing the child, the children of God, the child of God? So there's a lot to explore with all of that, but really just imagining what Mary's labor was like, what the birth of Jesus, what the Buddha's birth was like. Apparently Buddha's mother was also a virgin, and it was an artificial insemination by God, or a divine insemination. She didn't have a human father. Apparently she didn't have human sex with a male to get pregnant. So virgin birth as well. So imagining what all the mothers of the gods, the sons of gods, have experienced. And that's where the butterfly in the pelvis came from. So I feel it was channeled by the Virgin Mary, or at least my contemplations of her. So thank you. Share. Acknowledge. If people ask where it came from, say it came from the contemplations of the Virgin Mary's birth. As per Marcia Lopez from Women's Training. Thank you, everyone.